Welcome to this DM7 series video in collaboration with Waves. We are looking at the new WSG-PY64 I/O card. Waves and Yamaha have a long history of working together. Over 20 years ago, the Y56K card first brought Waves plugins to Yamaha AW series audio workstations. And since then, we have seen several generations of WSG-Y16 card, bringing SoundGrid connectivity to any Yamaha device fitted with MY card slots. WSG-HY128 is also available for Rivage PM series systems. SoundGrid is Waves' network system of software and hardware solutions for both multi-track recording and low-latency plug-in processing. There are many sizes and types of device available, but for us here, we have SuperRack software running on a computer and an Extreme C server to host the plugins and the WSG-PY64 card for interfacing audio with the PY slot in the DM7 series console. To use WSG-PY64, make sure your DM7 series firmware is version 1.7 or newer. Then it will allow 64 channels of audio in and out of the console at 48 or 96 kilohertz. The PY slot appears in all the patch grids, so you can use input channels, direct outputs, inserts, mix buses, recording patch, and so on. For proper use, WSG-PY64 and the Waves server need to be in the same network, and this needs to be separate from Dante. Use a different network switch, or use a different VLAN which hasn't been optimized for Dante, as SoundGrid has different preferred settings for QoS and other switch functions. If using a Yamaha SWP1 or 2, you can use preset A or B and make use of the second VLAN. Add the computer, which is running SuperRack SoundGrid, to the same subnet. Keep the computer's network port running with DHCP for automatic IP addressing. Before starting the software, let's make a brief mention of word clock, as all digital audio systems need to be synchronized. For us, it's best to set the DM7 or its built-in Dante module as the source. Open the setup menu in one of the DM7's bay screens and select word clock. Select internal 96 kHz to make the DM7 the leader of both the SoundGrid and the Dante networks. Otherwise, select Dante 96 kHz to allow another Dante device to become the leader. Or you could choose 48 kHz if you need, but this system will work well at 96 kHz. There are no settings to make on the console for the WSG-PY64 card or the SoundGrid network. Instead, we will use the SuperRack SoundGrid app. After opening it, look at the setup screen. On the left side of the screen, select Inventory. Probably your port selection, host computer and server are already selected from a previous project, but you will need to add the WSG-PY64 card. Click one of the plus boxes in the I/O devices list and find the WSG-PY64 in the list of network devices. Clicking ID will highlight the card's status light with multicolored flashing. In the servers list, there should be at least one active server. I can see my Extreme C there. Again, you can use the ID function just to make sure. Back with the control computer, if you wish to handle SoundGrid audio connections directly, perhaps for a multi-track recording to a DAW, then open its menu and set the number of driver channels you wish to use, and set the driver network buffer to something appropriate so there are zero errors appearing in the routing view on the right side of the screen. In the patch menu, you can make the audio connections between WSG-PY64 and the computer. Use these to make a live recording or multi-channel playback. If you only want to insert plugins via the server, you don't need to make any patch here. Rather, go straight to the Overview 1 screen and look at racks 1 to 16. At the top of a rack channel, select an input from the drop-down menu. Racks can be mono or stereo, or even multi-channel. Select from the WSG-PY64 card, and notice the rack output is patched at the same time. To save time, you could use the Auto Route All Racks option found in the preset menu. Select to route bank A or bank B, as the racks have two banks of available inputs for fast switching of multi-channel sources. Before we see audio through the racks, we have to make a patch on the console for the WSG-PY64. It's most likely that you'll want to insert plugins on input and output channels. So select the first channel you wish to use and look at the insert screen. Select an appropriate insert point and touch one of the inserts A to D. Then select outboard. Using a sequential patch here, we'll assign outboard to a range of channels. Then each insert output and input port needs to be assigned on a per channel basis. Make sure you use the same PY port number for the insert output and input. And don't forget to switch the channel inserts on. I have arranged to have a SoundGrid rack of input inserts, which are mostly mono, and a rack of output inserts, which are all stereo. Now we are ready to choose some plugins. Of course, Waves has a really wide range of plugins to choose from. Why not use the smart new Curves AQ? An autonomous EQ with target curves tailored to different musical genres. Or IDX Intelligent Dynamics to give greater punch and focus with frequency-dependent compression. Waves Tune Real Time is a good one to use for pitch correction on live vocals, while Feedback Hunter can be useful on loud stages. Then, of course, there's Waves' wide choice of emulation and coloration plugins, including the Abbey Road, CLA, and Renaissance ranges. If you're not sure where to start, there are factory presets available for a lot of instrument and vocal types. Find them in the preset menu, top left of the window. Using a SoundGrid server such as this Extreme C, you can run hundreds of plugins in real time. You'll probably run out of time before you run out of resources. By now, it would be a good time to store the SuperRack settings into a snapshot and then save a session. Then it will be possible to link a DM7 scene recall with a SuperRack snapshot recall. For that, you need a USB link between the DM7 USB to host port and the computer running SuperRack. Install the Yamaha Steinberg USB driver, version 3.1.6 or newer. In the SuperRack setup, add a MIDI controller and open its configuration cog. Select Yamaha DM7 port 1 for MIDI in and set Snapshot Recall to follow program changes on your preferred channel. I shall use number 1. In the show screen, look at the snapshots. Each snapshot can have an external ID number assigned to it. This will correspond to a MIDI program change, though bear in mind there is an offset between SuperRack and the DM7, so selecting 0 will correspond to number 1 in DM7. Number 1 in SuperRack will correspond to number 2 in DM7, and so on. Now we can prepare DM7 to transmit the messages. Open the Setup menu and look at MIDI GPI. In the MIDI Setup, select USB and enable Program Change TX. Select the same MIDI channel as SuperRack, so channel 1 for me. Now, open the Scene list and look at the MIDI table. Enable MIDI transmission for the required scenes and touch set. Now choose a message using USB channel 1 with a program change command. Then select the number to match the SuperRack snapshot, remembering that offset of 1. Program the remaining scenes you wish to recall a SuperRack snapshot, and then you're ready to run the show. So, that's a brief overview of the new Waves WSG-PY64 card, used for including DM7 series in all sizes of SoundGrid environment. Look up waves.com for further information, and keep your eyes on this channel for more DM7 series training content in the near future. See you soon.